All right. So good evening, everyone. This is our new coach Zoom for Thursday. I never know the date. I think it's August 20th. I don't know. I feel like I stopped caring about the date 5 months ago, but thank you all so much for being here. My name is Ashley Howard. So you are most likely one of my coaches or you're in my downline organization. So my whole purpose for this call is to make it 30 minutes or less to tell y'all what you need to do as new coaches and to have you leave this call just ready to take action. Because we can motivate you, we can pump you up, we can do all these things. But the reality is, like, this business is just taking action every day. And as a new coach, you don't really get the luxury to take time off because this is a side hustle for everyone. You know, no one is going out the gate making a ton of money. You either have families or full-time jobs or something else going on in your life. So because of that, you gotta show up every day. I mean, if those are your goals to really get your business started, which I assume that it is because you're here on a Thursday night, that you just have to do the things. You don't have to do 100% of the things 100% of the time, but I'm going to really break down what you need to be doing as a new coach. We're also going to do a little push at the end for a goal that I want everyone on this call to push for. And even if you have achieved that goal, I want you to achieve that goal again. So that's really how this business gets started. And we're going to dive right in. I will be asking you to participate a little bit in the chat when that time comes, so get ready. But if you guys have absolutely any questions, I feel like I say that and no one ever asks any questions. And then I think about it for me and I'm like, I never ask questions. If I'm on a group chat, I don't ask a question because I don't want to be the person who asks the question. But I always appreciate when other people do. So there's nothing silly about asking a question while I'm going through this stuff. If you don't understand it, ask it. It's the only way you're going to learn. You guys are new coaches. We don't overwhelm you with training because if we did that, you would run away. So we're going to ease you in, but if things don't make sense, that's why we're here to really answer your questions. So let's get going. I'm going to share my screen. And again, my goal is 30 minutes. We'll be out of here. I just want you to get the information. I want you to get excited to start. And then I want you to start because you could be excited and not start. And then you're not going to see growth in your business. So let's talk about exactly what needs to happen as a new coach. Okay. Hopefully my mute. Could you guys hear me? My volume was all the way down. To this day, all right, let me share my screen now. Okay. Hopefully I wasn't like completely muted that whole time because I realized my volume was pretty darn low. So let's get started. Does someone give me a thumbs up if they can see my screen, please? Okay, thank you. Okay. So welcome to our team. We're so excited that you guys are here to learn more about this business, and you're probably a new coach or someone who's been a coach for a minute and you maybe don't really know where to start. And that's really what this whole call is about. So I want to get right into it and I want to explain a little bit about what you should be doing on a daily basis. I want to give you guys some inspiration. I want to give you action steps. So welcome. We are really excited that you're here. I think the best thing that you can do is be a part of this business for more than just a discount. A discount is great, but if you're going to really dive into this business, you're going to be committing to your health and your fitness, and you're going to be committing to some financial goals that get you excited to help other people. The more you lean into the business, the more accountable you're going to be to your own health. And I think that's pretty much why you all are here, is you want to live a healthy life and you want to be able to pay it forward along the way. So let's just talk real quick. I want you to get out that little chat box because I want you to participate. I want you to put in the chat box what program, what Beachbody workout program you are following right now. If you're not following one, that is step one. Get on a program. I'm sure I'm going to see a lot of MBFs. I'm not going to pull up the chat because I'll get distracted. I'm probably going to see a lot of Muscle Burns Fat Advanced. A lot of you are doing different things. I know we have a couple coaches in test groups right now, but your job as a new coach is your journey. Consistency with your journey. Drink your Shakeology every day. That is the easiest thing you can do for your nutrition. And seriously, just how is that happening? Is someone drawing on my, I didn't touch it. I don't know what is up with the PowerPoint today. If someone's drawing, could you stop drawing on my PowerPoint? That is so weird, you guys. I'm not touching it. Let's just keep going. Maybe they'll draw a doodle. So being proof that the products work is number one for your health and your fitness and your business. Follow your calendar for your Beachbody program. Take your before photos and make sure that you're showing up daily in your stories to share that you're following a program. And the best thing that you can do when you complete a program is to share your transformation. Even if it wasn't a huge weight loss or weight gain or whatever your journey is, You take people along the road. You don't just do day 80 and then you show up and you're like, look at my transformation. Part of your job is sharing the journey every step of the way. That's how your network will really build trust with you. So number one, if you take nothing else away, choose a workout program, drink your Shakeology, and follow it. And the first day that you miss your workout or you just eat like complete crap, number one, you're human. But that's the most important day of your business because the next day you wake up and you get back on track. That's what being a coach means. It means not letting a small slip become an entire slide. So that is number one. Number two, you don't have to answer this in the chat. I just want you to make sure that you're getting your wheels turning. You're gonna hear a lot about your why. You're gonna hear a lot about the reason. Why did you become a coach? What's your goals with your business, with your finances? And honestly, I've been a coach for so long, my why has adapted and evolved so many times. But the reason being, I'm still here because I always had a why. I always had a reason to build my business. I always had a reason to not quit. If you see on social media, if you follow me, I just put up a post tonight about how I literally had a panic attack the first time I tried to talk to anyone about what I did. And it was my cousin at Thanksgiving dinner and I was like choking on turkey and I was so nervous and I was so panicked. And that's the difference between I could have quit and I could have said, I'm just bad at this. I can't even like call myself a coach. To fast forward 8 years this November, unfortunately, my cousin, who I wanted to be a coach, is struggling as a personal trainer because gyms are still very locked down here in Pennsylvania. And meanwhile, I've had financial freedom for the last 5 years with this business, income disclaimer, right? So like I could have given up, even though I had that embarrassing conversation, but I kept showing up because I believed in my vision. And my vision was I hated my corporate job. I was $50,000 plus in student loan debt, and I didn't want to be a server the rest of my life. I knew I was smart and disciplined enough to work for myself. I just knew it was going to take time. So number one is whatever that is for you. And now as a mom and as a, you know, soon to be mom of two, like my why is very different. But for you, what's the reason you're here? And to help people is great and to get healthy is great. But what is it? Like for me, I don't apologize. I've always been financially motivated in this business. It's always been the finances that drive me. Some of my other coaches, not so much. They're motivated by community, by recognition, by travel, by whatever, by being able to be home with their families, whatever it may be, whatever their goals are. You just have to figure out what are some reasons that you're gonna show up. Because if you don't have a reason, if it's just like, I kind of want to help people, I'm telling you, it's not strong enough. That's gonna get you working your business every day. It's just not strong enough. It has to light a fire in your belly. And think about that. And so number three is if you want to take notes to you guys, I think this would be really helpful to put into action after this call. What are you about? I think sometimes with coaches, new coaches, we think we have to post about health and fitness all the time. And if a lot of your posts are about your health journey because it's new, that's great. But I think in terms of posting and sharing your journey, we need to think like in a circle. Health and fitness is a piece of the pie. What are the other slices? So for me, it's wife and mom and pregnancy journey and moving and home decor, like all of that is something that I'm really enjoying at this point in my life. It doesn't mean that's always going to be my brand. It means that's my brand right now. So for you, I would literally take 30 seconds and jot down, like, what are your hobbies? And if you say you don't have a hobby, cool, I don't either. What's your job? What do you do with your friends in your spare time? What do you do with your family in your downtime? All of that is part of who you are. And all of that should be represented in your posts. Not all the time, every day, but pieces of your story are showing up on social media. It's not just health and fitness all the time. It's, do you love dogs? Do you garden? Do you cook? All of that should come in. So once you become a coach, it's not all of a sudden my life stops and here's my Beachbody business. It's Beachbody is just a part of it, right? So start to brainstorm, especially when you're new and starting to post, it can feel like, what do I post? Number one, I share a business plan every weekday morning in our team page. I give you guys ideas of what to post, different types of things, okay? But I don't want you to overthink it. I just want you to get a post up once a day with your face in it. That's what I want you to do as new coaches. You should have gotten $10 off promo codes as new coaches. If you didn't, reach out to your upline, check your spam folder. But as a new coach who signed up within the last 30 days, you should have gotten an email from Beachbody that gives you $10 off a promo, like for, to give out promo codes for challenge pack sales. That is awesome. You utilize that, leverage that when you're talking to people about joining you. You have three promo codes to give out. So use them just like if you're in Team Cup, we have promo codes as well. I've been leveraging them because everyone wants a sale and everyone wants that sense of urgency to snag one. So make sure as you're going through inviting, which we'll cover in a second, that you are knowing you have those three promo codes in the back of your pocket. So two things that as new coaches, now, not all of you, I'm not everyone's personally sponsored coach on this Zoom, and I know that. So some of my coaches lead their own team call. Some of them plug them into mine. Either way, it's completely fine. But know what your team does, okay? So number one, this is something for everyone. The national wake-up call, it's a Zoom. It's not a call, it's just like this, is for every single Beachbody coach out there. It's run by our corporate office. It can be found on the Team Beachbody Coach 411 page. And can one of my coaches type that in, Team Beachbody Coach 411 Facebook page? All you have to do is go like that Facebook page and you'll get a notification every Monday. It's 11 a.m. Eastern. If you don't make it, if you work or whatever, it's no big deal. It's recorded right there on the same page. My goal for new coaches is never miss a wake-up call, because that's gonna give you current events, you're gonna hear from corporate, you're gonna sometimes hear from our CEO, and you're going to hear from a successful coach who's sharing her tips with you, his or her tips with you. So that, I always say, whatever you do, just watch the National Wake Up Call sometime that week before the next Monday. I prefer early in the week as you can. If you can catch it live, even better. And our Team Glow is my organization, and if you're in my downline, you're a part of it too. We have a team Zoom at this time, 8:30 Eastern, every Monday. Okay, so if your coach leads another call and she's plugging you into that, do that one. That's your coach, that's your mentor. But if I'm your coach, or if your coach gets plugged into mine, be every effort that you can to be on live on Mondays. That's the one opportunity we get to be together as a team. And that's really something that I always try to bring, hopefully valuable content to you. Sometimes I have guest speakers, but we do recognition. We talk about what's new and exciting and coming up in our team and in Beachbody. So plug those two things as a recurring reminder in your phone. I know some people have issues with not getting reminders in their phone. For me, on my iPhone, as long as it's a recurring reminder in my calendar, I get a pop-up 10 minutes before anything, as long as it's recurring. If you don't, maybe set an alarm. But that's something that really, it's truly gonna make you feel a part of this team. The people that show up on these calls regularly are the people that are growing their business. There's no coincidence there. They're more invested, so they're putting in more effort. And then lastly is Eat That Frog. It's a book I read when I first started my coach journey. It's kind of boring, so I don't know that I'd recommend it, but it was a great concept of hopefully no one here wants to eat a frog. If you do, that's cool. But basically Eat That Frog means do the thing you're most likely going to put off first thing in your day. So for some of you, that might be your workout. For some of you, that might be your personal development. For others, it might be messaging people because that terrifies you. If you just do it and you do it early enough that that's the first thing you conquer in the day, you've already won your morning. The rest of your day, work, kids, family, whatever it is, going back to your business and doing more things, you've already got a jump start. So whatever your frog is in this business, you might already know because you might have tried to do it and then you just stop. Do that. Do that first thing in your day. Okay, so what do I do? As a new coach, you guys, this is something that, like, if you're not gonna be on the personal development train, you're not gonna get very far in your business. I know people say it's cheesy. I know people say they haven't done it. You listen to any successful coach and that's a part of their daily, daily routine. Personal development is something that we listen to or we read. It's a book or it's a podcast or it's an Audible book on, you know, tape or whatever they call it. This will help you with so many things in your life. We have a ton of personal development recommendations. My favorite to start coaches on is the 5-second rule. If someone can write that down, typed in the chat, by Mel Robbins. It's super entertaining. She's awesome. And she talks about just doing the things. So not letting fear hold you back. But having personal development, it's recommended like 10 minutes a day. So that could be when you wake up and you read, or you before you go to bed, you read. I just couldn't do that because I'd fall asleep. I actually do my personal development while I'm working out and while I'm getting ready in the morning. So that those two things help me knock it out in the day. I listen to mine. I don't actually physically read, but it helps me before I ever open up my social media. Okay, so as coaches, what should you be doing? Well, if you wanna grow your business, remember it's your choice. If you wanna grow every day, you should post at least once a day. I post the exact same thing on my Facebook page as I do on my Instagram. My picture, my face is in my post pretty much 100% of the time, unless it's randomly my daughter, because people are going to connect with me. They're not going to connect with someone they don't know or a picture of a sunset. They're going to connect with me. Okay. Use stories. Don't overcomplicate it. Use stories throughout the day. I do it my Energize. I take a video clip of me working out and then I share my life. You can get fun with them. I'm terrible with graphics. I keep my stories super basic, but if that overwhelms you, just think threes. Do three stories in the morning, three at lunch, three at night. Okay. Then you will always have stories in a 24-hour period. And that's a better way for people to really see what's going on in your life. Message supporters, the people who are liking your posts and watching your stories. If you don't direct message in this business, you will not get very far. People are not going to come to you. They will every once in a while if you have an amazing transformation or something. But most people, even me, almost 8 years into this business, I reach out to 99% of people that have become customers, become coaches on my team. My inbox isn't being flooded with people being like, I am so ready for you to be my coach. No, I reach out to them and it's usually not right away that they join me, but they're watching me. And I invite, and you should be inviting every day. We have a really great template in Team Glow in the file section called Inviting Templates, but I walk you through how to invite someone. So that's it's simple. I don't invite someone out of the blue. If someone's liking my fitness post that I shared my journey, I'm gonna invite them because they liked that post, they supported it. And I'm gonna do it in a way that feels very natural and authentic to me, but I'm not gonna overcomplicate it. If it's a picture of me and my daughter, I'm not gonna invite someone to join my fit club, but I'm gonna message them and ask how they're doing and thank them for their support. This is a human relationship building business. The one thing you need to do as a new coach that I think so often we drop the ball on is reach out to your friends and your family. Most likely, you guys, they're gonna be the first people to do this with you because they already love you. They know if you're doing it, like it's legit and you're enjoying it. So why would you not invite them to do this with you? And I'll give you the simplest invite. Are you ready? It's, hey mom, hey best friend from college, whatever it is. I just started this program. I honestly don't know everything about what I'm doing, but I'm really enjoying it. And I love this group and I'm working out at home. Would you want to do this with me? I thought it'd be fun to do together. Because when it's someone's, it's your friend or your family member, they're not going to think you're spamming them. They're not going to think you're just trying to make a sale. If you like them, you should want them to be more in your life. And maybe you could do a fitness program together and rekindle your friendship or bring your family members closer to you through health and fitness. I don't know what's better than that. So when you get off this call, I challenge you to just get out of your head and do it. It's so easy. And if they say no, you'll survive. It's okay. But they're going to watch you and then they're going to see you progress on your journey. And they, most of them are going to be ready 30 days down the road, 60 days down the road, 90 days down the road, because you have been consistent. Transformation post in your first week, or if you've been a coach for a while and you haven't done a transformation, cool. Do one tonight or tomorrow. It doesn't mean you have to have lost 100 pounds. It doesn't mean you have to have gone from like flab to 8-pack abs. What it means is you've had a transformation, even if this is your second day as a coach, because something shifted in you and you signed up to work this business. So it could be a mental transformation. It could be physical. Obviously, if you've had results with the products, use your transformation, but putting up any kind of side-by-side photo. And I always say, it doesn't have to be old me versus new me. It's me of a couple years ago or a couple months ago or a couple weeks ago. And here's me now. Here's what I'm learning on my journey. That's it. You don't have to say that you're all of a sudden a Beachbody coach. It's I'm on my health and fitness journey and here's the difference between the two photos. And I would love to help people the way my coach is helping me. That's a transformation post because you can invite from that post. Those are people that are clearly know you're on a journey and they want to do this and they're supporting you. So why would you not invite them instead of just starting a random conversation? I hope that makes sense. And then set your daily numbers. You know, your goals, your numbers should match your goals. I can't tell you what's right and what's wrong. I can only tell you that if you want to achieve Success Club, which I've got to speed up because we've got 10 minutes, but I'm going to go through all this. If you want to hit Success Club, which is very important as a coach, you're going to need to talk to people every day. So setting your numbers of, okay, 6 days a week, how many people am I going to talk to that are new conversations? I would say as a new coach, if you're talking to, let's say, 10 new people a day at 6 people a week, that's 60 people a week. That's several hundred people a month that you are now talking to. And a lot of those are going to turn into invites because you're already being so clear that you're on a health and fitness journey. Okay. So one thing that we want everyone to do, and this is the challenge that we're going to share with you guys at the end, is become an Emerald coach. There are so many benefits to it. It means that you are a coach and you're active, which I'm sure you're, if you're using product and you're a coach, you're active. You have one coach on the left side of your organization and one coach on the right side of your organization. You don't have to worry about the ins and outs of the organization right now, but just know when you sign two coaches who are also active on product of at least 50 volume points, a volume point is roughly a dollar, you will become on the following Thursday, because that's when our weeks change, officially an Emerald coach, okay? So why should you go for Emerald? Well, number one, if you're enrolling someone to join you, you should offer up the coach slash team membership because coaches get a discount. Even if this person's not interested in building their business, and most people probably won't be at the beginning, why would you not want them to save money down the road, right? So I always offer up, do you want to sign up as a customer or a coach? I recommend coach, it saves you money, no pressure to work your business, the opportunity's there. So if you do that twice, you'll become an Emerald coach by next Thursday. And a lot of times, there's a whole other training on signing up your spouse. It's very important to do if you plan to really build your business, because if your spouse is placed, or significant other, you don't have to be married or family member, if they're placed at the top of your business, you will benefit in the long run having signed them up first or second, but very towards the top of your organization. That could be your first coach, and you can control their account. You can pay for their business fee. It's basically like opening up another second coach account. But when you are Emerald and you achieve Success Club, which I'll go over in the next slide, you will get assigned customers from Beachbody. Sometimes it's a lot, sometimes it's a little, but you're gonna see customers show up in your Beachbody office that have just ordered through the Beachbody website. You're going to unlock the ability to earn team cycle volume. So I don't have time to go into team cycle volume tonight, but we all earn commissions, right? We earn what commissions of whatever we sell or help people get started with. The more exponential income in this business comes from building a team and helping them reach their goals and help them produce volume, because volume you're paid out on as an Emerald coach and above. And that to me, you guys, is like 90% of my paycheck. You get team recognition and personal recognition, and it's your first step towards becoming a diamond coach, which is basically the next step in your business of having a team of at least 8 coaches and 2 Emeralds. So Success Club, this is where everyone, if you can understand nothing else about being a coach, if you hit Success Club monthly, you're gonna grow your business. So Success Club is our monthly qualification. Every Beachbody coach starts out at 0 points on the first of every month. So you get 2 points per one person that enrolls with a challenge pack or Shakeology Home Direct are the easiest ways to get Success Club points, okay? If you sign 2 people, remember for Emerald, 2 coaches or team members, whatever you wanna call them, with challenge packs, you not only become an Emerald coach, you earn $100 because you get approximately $50 commission per challenge pack. You must achieve at least 5 Success Club points. Now it's usually 6 because we get 2 points per person a month and have an order of 90 personal volume points in the month as well. So if you're drinking Shakeology and you help 3 people, cool, you hit Success Club, right? Of course, there's more that goes into it than that. We have to invite and connect and post. But if your goal is by the end of the month, you always help at least 3 people and you're on your own personal order of Shakeology, you're going to achieve Success Club. The beauty of that is we have a benefit called Success Starters. So from your sign up date as a coach, you have 6 months. If you achieve Success Club at least 3 of those months, and I would say go for it every month because that's the secret of my success. I've never missed Success Club for 6.5 years. You will become a Success Starter. And a couple of people on this call have been Success Starters. You get a free ticket to our annual convention next year, which hopefully we can go to, and you get to be in a test group of an upcoming fitness program, which is awesome. 2 of my coaches are in test groups right now and I'm super jealous. You also get Success Club trip dollars. So every spring, Beachbody sends us on a rewards trip. Certain people get invited based on their Success Club points. That's the only way my husband and I like get a vacation every year. So pending the pandemic, we will be in Mexico in April, and every Success Club point that you earn gets you closer to an invite and gets you closer to getting your costs covered for that trip. You can earn your trip, which is awesome. That's how we travel. That's how we go on vacations. I love travel. So that was a really big game changer for me when I knew I could push for a vacation. Recognition, of course, and income growth. I'm going to go over these really quick, but basically income progression for me, again, huge income disclaimer, Beachbody is really cracking down on us not making any false claims, which I am not. Beachbody cannot guarantee any level of success or income. Each success is based on the coach's individual skill. But for me, I've been a coach for a long time. As an Emerald coach, I pulled some of these a couple months ago, but I earned in a random week I think this is probably 2014, I earned $162. Not bad. And that was only retail commission. It was only the sales I had made. Fast forward a year from that point, I had built my team. I had a couple leaders really emerge on my team because I wasn't just helping customers. I was building a team. I earned $1,139. And if you can see there, the picture is kind of covering it for me, but I did have retail commission, but I had a matching bonus. I have other bonuses that happen when you start to grow your team of coaches, not just of retail customers. And then again, income disclaimer, this was last month sometime. I now have three business centers. So actually have four. I have my first, my second, my husband's, and my third. So this is just one of four, but back then it was one of three. This is my highest paid earning business center. But as a four-star diamond coach, look at that, you guys. I had a negative retail commission. I had negative $25. Someone returned something. But my team bonus, which again is the cycle volume that you can only start to earn, and it's small, right? It'll build over time. You can only earn that as an emerald and above. But my team bonus that week was $3,276, not to mention the other things that I can earn as a coach with commissions and subscription commissions and building my team and opening up another business center. Now, if that just like went over your head, don't worry about it. Just know that if you're in this for the long haul and you have financial goals, you have to be building a team. And the first step is become an emerald coach. Okay, I'm almost done. We might go like 2 minutes over, but I'll make this quick. This is a learn then do business, or sorry, a do then learn. You cannot sit there and do a million trainings and then close your computer and think that you worked your business. I would rather you do zero training, post and talk to people. That's it, you guys. Like, I think we overcomplicate this so much when it's, did I post? Did I show up on social media? And did I talk to people? Did I message someone? Did I start a connection or did I invite people? And if you start taking action, you will learn as you go. And I'm gonna be really bold here and tell you that it's the 20th of the month. You all have 10, 11 days until August 31st. None of you have anything holding you back from achieving Success Club and becoming an Emerald Coach before the end of the month, okay? If you really want this, like if you're really like, okay, I'm fired up, I wanna do this, how do I do it? Go invite 100 people. If you invite 100 people, three of them will most likely join. But I think sometimes as new coaches, we think, I invited five people and no one joined and three of them ghosted me and one said no. That's normal. Welcome to working with people. But if you can create your friends and family list, if you can do a transformation post, and if you can really go through and just be so genuine and honest in your inviting of the people that you already know, you will be able to start inviting people that you're meeting because you're connecting with them and now they're watching you. So if someone likes your dog post, that's great, send them a message. If that same person is watching your stories 2 days later and you're working out every day in your stories, or they like your Fitness Friday post where you're talking about your workout program, invite that person. Who cares if you only messaged them 2 days ago? They're supporting you. So the more you can message people, the better, but also the more you can just jump right in and invite people that you know in a very genuine way that sounds like you, the better. Your business will grow in your inbox. My advice, you know, I just spoke on a call the other day and like none of them use Facebook. And I was like, what? They build their business strictly on Instagram? That's fine. But I think you're missing a huge, huge market if you're not diving into your Facebook market. Because you can post the same. I post the exact same things to Instagram to Facebook. But even now, as being a coach for so long, I'm still helping people with my Facebook network. Instagram is awesome. I love it. For me, it just takes longer to build those relationships. Brandy's not speaking on there. I forgot to edit that. But that's all I have. I have one more thing, and it is our challenge. So my challenge for you, look, and I made it at just about 30 minutes, and then I'll check for questions. Anyone, actually, what I'm going to do is end the recording here because this is only for you if you're on live. So if you're watching the recording, sorry, bye. Go work your business.